Hi, this is Roderic Burke, a Franciscan friar and a former engineer. And I'm introducing a new video series called Married to the Moon, where I will discuss the relationship between faith and science and their roles in true human progress. In regard to faith, I will emphasize devotion to Mary, and for science, space travel. Contrary to common opinion, there are many similarities between space travel and spirituality. And I will contend there is a need for spirituality to keep human progress on track and even from crashing and burning. This potential for progress or peril is especially true regarding our rapidly advancing rocket science, since it can be used for the greatest of human progress or for our utter destruction. But this topic is also very timely, since there is a growing consensus that we are about to start a new, more spectacular space race than the one from when I was a kid. This will require people of faith and church leaders to consider how they will participate and have their spiritual needs met in space, but also how we as a society will have to deal with the disruption and materialism that such advancements tend to bring, against which spirituality offers the only adequate remedy. So there are many reasons to combine these topics, but perhaps the most important one is that I love rockets and Mary, although not in that order. And well, it's time to blast off with the premiere of Mary to the Moon, where science and faith come together for true progress. So the main reason so many people think we are headed out to a new space race, including myself, is due to the massive reductions in costs to launch rockets by employing reusable rockets as pioneered by Elon Musk and his company SpaceX, which is currently creating so much media buzz, reawakening and vindicating the faded hopes from the last space age. During the 50s, 60s, and finally the 70s, when we last landed on the moon, there were high hopes of starting permanent colonies in space. To make this happen in a feasible way, many concept designs were done by NASA and other leading aerospace institutions to circumvent the high cost of launching material from Earth by making use of resources from the moon and asteroids, which are already in space. This would enable us to build the kind of space habitats, facilities, and spaceships that we think of as pure science fiction. However, these ideas all require the ability to launch sufficient quantities of astronauts, equipment, and supplies to get started. Thus, we've been in a catch-22 where the cost of launching anything up till now has been so radically high that the cost of avoiding these costs has been totally prohibitive. The recently retired space shuttle costs $7,500 per pound to launch things. This gallon of water that weighs 8 pounds would cost about $60,000 to launch, which is the same price as a city bus. That's an awful high price to pay to fetch a pail of water. SpaceX has already brought the cost down almost tenfold, but as I will address in a future episode, I was totally shocked to find that the cost of launching material will drop in the next decade by a factor of over 200-fold as compared to the shuttle, to about $33 per pound. So that same gallon of water will only cost $264, or about the cost of this electric skateboard. Here they are shown to scale to give you an idea. Still expensive for a gallon of water, but this means you can do far, far more with current space budgets. As such, barring any disasters on Earth, I think full-scale space colonization is going to happen. With such high prospects for colonization, the Catholic Church will have to start formulating plans for how to take care of the spiritual needs of this new spacefaring population. We will need chapels, churches, and even cathedrals on these bases and space stations. Hey, I like to think big. And even form parishes and dioceses and develop new strategies for evangelization. However, there's another rather ominous similarity between this space race and the last. As we are gearing up for our great adventure out to space, we are also experiencing greater polarization and strife, both within many countries, including the U.S., but also internationally. Likewise, the last space race took place in the context of the Cold War and during the domestic unrest of the countercultural and anti-establishment movements. This strife can easily derail all of our new hopes. With such large percentages of our population experiencing dissatisfaction and disenfranchisement, at a point in history when we have unheard of wealth and with so much hope for even more prosperity, it is clear that we have a need for something beyond mere material wealth. This something extra is spirituality, a relationship with God. This is what every individual needs to find fulfillment in this life and in the hereafter, but it'll also enable us collectively to find the unity and peace that we need to get to the heavens, that is space, and when we get there, to make those heavens a truly heavenly place for building a great civilization. In fact, the main problem in our modern technological society is a lack of spirituality, which is essentially materialism, placing all of our hopes for happiness on material things and pleasures. By definition, a lack of spiritual orientation is materialistic. Since technology has no spiritual dimension, then left by itself, it will lead to materialism. Materialism is, in turn, the main source of the problems in our modern world, like pollution, moral decadence, debt, bad health, family breakdown, and inequality of wealth. All of these are hot-button issues that become the rallying cries of the liberal left and conservative right, where each side sees the other as the cause of the problems they are concerned about. In short, it not only causes serious problems, it is divisive. As such, even if technology has the potential to unite, this unitive fruit will not come forth without spirituality. An example is social media, where everyone was very surprised that such an inherently unitive technology could lead to polarization as it has. Thus, technology without spirituality just starts a fight and provides the high-tech weapons to make that fight very bloody and very destructive. The same rockets that helped us leap into the space age can even more easily nuke us back to the Stone Age. So yes, this can derail all of our hopes for stepping out into space. But even if we are successful and begin to profitably tap into the vast resources of space, it will unleash even higher levels of materialism. As some of the most recognized experts point out, the world's first trillionaires will be those who pioneer the mining of space, flooding the globe with new material wealth. As such, we need a corresponding advancement in the spiritual life with its unitive power in order to counterbalance the resulting materialism and avoid explosive division. The new space race is merely a particularly opportune time to address a long-standing need to return to spirituality. As mentioned, spirituality is not as far removed from space travel as is commonly assumed. The heavens, that is, the sky and the stars have been considered the abodes of the gods long before Christianity, with all the planets and stars named after them. The Christian God is purely spiritual, but the idea of traveling toward him on a spiritual journey that starts during our earthly life and ends in heaven where we dwell with him is all the more analogous with space travel. Again, what's most interesting is that the moon is an ancient symbol of Mary, who is our intercessor in developing a relationship with God. In the case of space travel, the moon is being viewed as a middle ground, acting in the same intercessory fashion. So the rocket scientists may be closer to our spiritual mother than they thought. As such, going from Earth to space using rockets and using the moon as a waypoint is like going from worldly material concerns to union with God using spirituality and Mary as a mediator. Both journeys start by recognizing the limitations of where we're at and are heading out to open new frontiers. Astronauts to open new colonies on planets and space stations, religious people to reach out in prayer beyond this material created world to God and ultimately to heaven. The moon provides the help for the difficult journey to Mars and beyond. Mary helps in the journey to God, bringing us to her divine Son. If the moon is for the glory of mankind, then Mary is for the glory of God. This series will unite the two, thus the title, Mary to the Moon. Materialism excludes one of these, and this exclusivity explains its divisiveness, drawing people into small, exclusive groups, boxing them in and setting them against each other. Materialism is a spiritual equivalent of being stuck on a planet without a rocket. In contrast, spirituality is the reaching out to the infinite God, and so is the ultimate in thinking outside the box. It explains its unitive nature, breaking the self-indulgent, self-centered aspect of materialism. Again, our longing to go to the stars is akin to a longing for heaven and God. Spirituality is a relationship between God and man, so it includes both. This is also in contrast to fundamentalism that also rejects one of these in its inhuman holiness. This both-and aspect of spirituality will be the main focus of what I think needs to be added to our technological endeavors in order for them to bring forth their unitive potential for sustained human progress. Again, Mary puts the focus on this both-and unitive nature of spirituality, in that her Son is both God and man in one person. And so he personifies this spiritual unity between God and humanity. And this unity took place in her womb. As such, devotion to Mary keeps the human family united together with God by adding a human, feminine, motherly touch to religion. Although including Mary in spirituality is nothing new, especially in the Catholic Church, I think some of these insights help both Catholics and non-Catholics to see why Mary is important, especially as a means to focus on the both and as the essence of spirituality, making an effective remedy for materialism that is the main plague of our times, and even more so as we step out into space. One of the outcomes I hope to achieve with this new spiritual outlook, combined with some ideas I have that are inspired by it, is to help everyone to stop focusing on the hot-button issues of our times, which has done nothing but generate more heat and contention. Rather, we can start focusing on the underlying materialistic disease that is the cause of these issues. This way, our efforts will not only be more effective because it removes the cause, but because both liberals and conservatives can agree that materialism and consumerism is bad. Focusing on reducing these will naturally get people working together, enabling us to get past the conflict and paralysis of polarization. And since growth in spirituality will be the main way to do this, which also is inherently unitive, this will bring to fruit the unitive aspects of technology, all combining to create a virtuous upward spiritual cycle that has as much promise for a new era of human progress and well-being as our new reusable rockets, if not more. We then have the possibility of uniting left and right, science and faith, technology and spirituality, new ways and old, and so enable the engines of progress to run on all cylinders on a smooth road for sustained growth. If we want to establish a permanent presence in space with very Earth-like colonies, then when the church bells toll for Sunday service, echoing through our new space colonies, lifting our minds to the eternal God, we will know we have done it, and have done it right. So yes, I think we will be venturing out into space, and we people of faith plan on coming along and pulling our weight in this great epic endeavor. This is truly a great time to be alive. Stay tuned to see how the series unfolds with many more insights, ideas, and solutions, both technical and spiritual. In case you're wondering, I'm a friar in the Franciscan Friars of the Immaculate, as in Mary, the Immaculate Mother of Jesus Christ. And yes, the Marian Franciscan Catholic spirituality that we practice here is the inspiration for this. St. Francis, the founder of the Franciscans, fought the materialism of his day with his radical rejection of riches and promoted the brotherhood of man with God and with all creation. Pope Francis took his name from St. Francis, and this explains his preference for the poor and his promotion of peace and progress. So I'm a former engineer. I used to work for a naval research center, and I've had a love for space and rockets since my youth when I saw the moon landing at age 6. I've also run a video website from the earliest days of YouTube and have all these ideas relating technology and spirituality that I don't hear mentioned elsewhere. So here we are. I'll try and keep these briefer going forward, for these will largely be a more in-depth presentation of the points I have made in this last talk. So as both a means of review and a look ahead, the next show will be on how space will lead to incredible levels of wealth and what is good about that, but also what are the pitfalls. The following show will go into more detail on how spirituality is the remedy for materialism and its divisiveness, and how Mary keeps a focus on this unity and avoids fundamentalism. And the next will be on techniques to reduce materialism in a pragmatic way, using the unifying mindset of spirituality based on Mary. Then we will return to some technical subjects, namely how to get into space with rockets and alternatives to rockets. So what do you think? Are we headed out to a permanent, self-sufficient presence in space soon? Will spirituality play a role in our space travels? Let us know in the comments. The goal is to start a conversation on these topics. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to us on YouTube and like us on your favorite social media. This will help us with how we rank on the search engines. You can also go to our donation page at airmaria.com to give some support that way. That's it for Mary to the Moon, where science and faith come together for true progress. Come back and watch us next time. And as we say in our community, as a greeting and a goodbye, Ave Maria, which means Hail Mary in Latin. So, Ave Maria, and God bless you.
Jesum per Maria.